And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Cleveland Guardians going up against the New York Mets. With my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaub. And we got a rubber match on our hands today, partner.
Yeah, the final game of a three-game set. They've split the first two, and regardless of how important a series is within the larger picture of the season, it's a game you want to get up for. Every series win feels good, so we should see a fun matchup in this one.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set on the hill here today, Aaron Nola. And Ziggy, he likes pitching at home.
Well, truly for him, there is no place like home. He's been so dominant here. And as a teammate, you expect him when pitching at home this year to go out and dominate just as he has. The fans expect it. And I think everyone around here knows that he's a good pitcher. Even though we don't see the same splits on the road, we're going to start to see that translate as well.
Drill to the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. That was a moonshot. His 19th home run of the year. It's 1-0.
Oh, that one won't stay below the radar. That made a lot of noise. We see this so much more today. Lineups with pop in the leadoff spot, and it really puts the pitcher in a tough spot out there where he has to execute right away. You can't just get over a couple of strikes to settle in, get comfortable, because at the plate, that guy's looking to do exactly what he just did. Start the game off with a huge bang.
And the batter now, Jason Dominguez. And Cleveland on top once in. Next offering misses, and that's ball two. When Nola was in college at LSU, he got a chance to play with his brother, Austin, who was the team shortstop, and as well his roommate was Alex Bregman. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Hampson grabs it on the run. Let's take a look at Terry Francona's lineup for the Guardians. This is a good offense, Chris. You're going to get quality at bats and balls put in play consistently with this group.
And it doesn't really matter who they're facing on the mound. They have the ability to go out and compete and win ball games. If it's an All-Star or Cy Young Award winner to just a rookie up in the big league. So when you have that, you have a chance to win every night. If I was a pitcher on this team, I'd feel pretty good about taking the mound for him.
Bounced up the middle. He's in there.
Well, he did all he could at short to try to make an amazing play and almost got it done, but good hustle down the line, and that's an earned infield hit.
Steven Kwan digs in now. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, a few things can go wrong when you are delivering a pitch. That grip, slip out of your hand, release point, wind up, all of those things. And I think it's safe to say at least one of those, if not more than one, got away from him.
And now it's Ahmed Rosario.
At this point, the clean inning is over. Got to settle in, focus on the hitter, and get out of it with minimal damage.
The 1-2. And that's outside.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
And down on strikes he goes. Good job at damage control right there. Another look here at the solo shot leading off the ball game. It's now a 1-0 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on The Show. Back here at Citi Field. On the hill here today, Tristan McKenzie. And Singy, that may be his name, but the strikeout is his game.
Well, Brooke, I can tell you've been working on that one, but yes, you are right. This guy strikeout for 9, over 11. I mean, that's just getting it done. There are a lot of strikeouts in that other lineup, and when you look at what he's able to do, man, it's going to be a fun one to watch today.
Bottom of the first, Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Kicks and deals. And down on strikes, and that's the first out.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. He tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Gonna count one and two.
One ball, two strikes.
Swings and misses. Back-to-back strikeouts.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with the number three hitter, any distraction can cause you to serve up a cookie, and instead of it being a solo shot, it's a two or three run homer. Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Misses outside. Three balls and a strike. Alonso off of first with two away. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
Nick Castellanos at the plate now. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving.
That one is absolutely belted. Out of here. Nick Castellanos goes deep. His ninth homer of the year. It's 3-1.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Chris Taylor now. 2-1 now. And a swing and a miss. Two, two now. And now it's filled up.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Struck him out looking. Mets get three on this homer. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. Top of the second, stepping up for the Guardians, Robert Hassel the third. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Fly ball down the line, Hampson. He ranges to his right. Great catch, foul ground up against the wall.
The first base is number four, Tyler.
Here's Tyler Freeman to hit.
Boog, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
1 down, base is empty. And there's a ball.
2-2.
This to third. Taylor whips it to first. Two up, two down.
Batting, huh? The catcher.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. Ball to strike. Out to short. Lindor. The throw to first. And that is that. Three up, three down for him there. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Mets three and the Guardians one. Back here in Queens, bottom of the second. Here's Jamai Jones.
The second baseman.
The pitch. High fly ball, right field. Hassel moving under it. Puts it away for the out. Now the catcher up to hit, Henry Geronimo. Good defender. He's been inconsistent offensively. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. The 1-2. On the ground, out to short. Tosses to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two.
Batting done.
Here's Garrett Hampson. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Trying to bunt his way on. And it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
To the right side. Over to first. That's the inning. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. But they still lead it 3-1. Top half of the third inning. Here's the Cleveland leadoff hitter, Jose Ramirez. It's interesting. He plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. One down.
The center fielder, number six. Jason.
And up next for Cleveland, Dominguez. Jason Dominguez. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. Right-hander kicks, deals. Pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike. Nola's a guy who registers a lot of strikeouts. In fact, he's had 220 or more strikeouts in three different seasons. Righty delivers. And there's a fly ball deep right field. And that one is out of here. He blasts one out to right. His 21st of the year. It's 3-2.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient and waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
And now it's going to be Patrick Connolly. And that one hit to first. Fouls that off to the left and we'll do it again. Three, two now. And a swing and a miss. And there's two away.
Not a great curveball there at all, but clearly he wasn't looking for it because it just dropped right into the happy zone. And it looked like, to me, the swing was a little bit late. tells me he gave up on it early and then just tried to have that emergency hack at the last second to put it in play.
And a pitch. Foul ball there. The 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. The 1-2. That one ripped. And it's gone. Shohei Ohtani goes deep. His 21st of the year, and we're level. It's 3-3.
Impressive how he was able to go down and get this fastball, but yet get it up in the air, hit it far enough to get out of this ballpark.
So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. He was plunked in his first trip to the plate. And he grounds one to the right side. Jones whips it to first. That ends the frame. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. We're tied now at 3 apiece. You're dialed into the show. As we go to the last of the third. And now the shortstop, Francisco Lindor. And the right-hander deals.
Well, these Mets showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. It's not just the three runs they've already scored. On top of that, they forced this starter to throw more pitches than he wanted to at this point of the game.
Dominguez makes the catch, and there's one gone.
And that pitch count is impactful because if they can keep making him work hard out there, it may force the bullpen to get involved a little sooner rather than later.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Next offering is in for a strike. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Everything came together for him. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
The punch out there, and there's two down.
Boogie gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult.
And there's the third out. That'll do it for the inning. Mets strand one. Score remains tied at 3. Back here at the ballpark, onto the fourth. And stepping in is the speedy Ahmed Rosario.
You know, these Guardians doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. It's not just the three runs they've already scored. On top of that, they forced this starter to throw more pitches than he wanted to at this point of the game.
And that'll fall for a base hit.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time, and guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Rosario gets his lead at first. Nobody out.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base trying to stay out of a double play here.
Rosario on the move. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. pitch. Runner goes again. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Left-hand batter waits. Runner on the move again. Popped in the air. Left field. Hampson hauls it in. One away.
And that pitch count is impactful because if they can keep making him work hard out there, it may force the bullpen to get involved a little sooner rather than later.
Rosario runs. Pitch inside. Throw, save. That's a stolen base.
Well, with a good arm behind the dish, it's definitely a roll of the dice here to try to steal second base. Man, he can zip it down there so quickly. That was a pretty good throw as well, but really good clean stolen base.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Got him out on the front foot. Couldn't keep the hands back long enough and played right into the hands of the pitcher.
The next offering misses, and that's ball three. The 3-1. Out to short. Fires over to first. Out number three. One left for the Guardians, so no change in the score. It's 3-3. And welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. And now the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. Next offering is in for a strike.
Pretty rare location right there, right down the middle. This guy paints the edges. I'm not sure if you're going to see that pitch again as a hitter.
Got him. One up, one down.
Committed to that breaking ball just a little too much and couldn't pull the bat back in time. You know, once you get it going, it can be so tough to stop the momentum of that barrel. Good pitch, had him fooled.
And a strike in there. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
Here's the second baseman, Jamai Jones. Slide out his first time. Next pitch misses inside, and it's 2-1. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and he got him. The big righty strikes out the side. Down in order go the Mets. Still tied, 3-3. Young girl, big dreams, thinking I was foolish. Welcome back. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's Jose Ramirez.
Jose Ramirez.
The why to kick the pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. Nimmo makes the catch. And there's one away.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it. But sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
And now here's a speed threat, outfielder Jason Dominguez. The 1-1. And that's outside. Great. 2-1 now. That one fouled off.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
3-2 now. And that's ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Man at first with one gone. Patrick Connolly digs in for the Guardians. Here's a 1-1. Runner on the go. In the dirt. Kicks away from the catcher. Blocked by the catcher, and he steals second base without a throw. To the mound. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. But no throw, and they'll have runners at the corners with one out.
Oh, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
One down, runner at first. Shohei Ohtani digs in for the guard. Runner on the go. Swing and a miss. Throw to second, and great jump.
Well, almost a strike him out, throw him out play right there, but 3-2 is a great count to run on. There's a good chance the hitter puts the ball in play, so it can turn into a big play offensively as well.
Here's the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. The pitch. Rolled slowly to first. Alonso takes it himself, and that'll do it. So one run on one hit, no errors, and a runner left. Last half of the fifth coming up. Guardians 4 and the Mets 3. Back here at Citi Field, here's the catcher, Henry Geronimo.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. That shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
Two down. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. Comes a 2-2. Goes down looking.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Hampson getting ready to hit. Rolled out to second in his first at bat. A wind and a pitch. Foul ball. And a pitch. Upstairs.
It's a good take.
Stays alive. Two, two now. Fights it off. He'll see another. Next offering is fouled back.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Next offering upstairs. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
Here's Francisco Lindor. The 1-1.
Hi.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Into center. Makes a nice running catch. And that is that. Mets go down quickly. Score holds at 4-3. The Mets with a new arm on the mound, Josiah Gray.
Well, he hasn't pitched in a while, coming on here after 5 days rest, so he should be rested, but we'll see if he has any rust to shake off.
Back here in Queens, start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and leading off, Ahmed Rosario. And he deals. Just missed. The 2-1. Lifted in the air, right center field. Puts it away for the out.
Now batting. Right fielder, Robert.
Stepping up for the Guardians, Robert Hassel III. The 1-1. Swing and a foul straight back. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. And I'm out front for strike three.
That right there is one of those breaking balls that you swing through and you feel like you should have done something with it or at least spoiled it away. But when it's breaking in on you like that, if the spin is tight enough, it can actually tie you up.
Swung on, belted. That's got a chance. And that one is going to go. He sends it out of here, and they add to their lead. It's 5-3. That's his third straight game with a homer, Singy.
This dude is on fire, Boo. These kinds of streaks just don't come around too often. He's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run. To the slight opposite field, into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Bo Naylor. The wind of the pitch. Ripped on a line. Nimmo squeezes it. And that is the third out of the inning. Solo shot for the Guardians this inning. It's now 5-3. And welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning. And stepping in for New York, Brandon Nimmo. 1-2 down. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
Well set to throw pitch number 100. He needs a quick inning here if he's going to be able to make it through six complete.
Fouls it off, still 1-2.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ball game at this point.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Kicks and fires. Right side to first, and that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
Now back, the first baseman.
Here's Pete Alonso. Singled and scored back in the first. He's 1-for-2. And here it comes. There's a swing and a miss. Chris, we were excited to watch him pitch. This is a little more along the lines of what we were expecting performance-wise.
Yeah, but great pitchers like this, you may get one opportunity in one inning to get to them, to get some runs up on the board. And if you don't take it then, you may see zeros the rest of the ballgame.
Slings to first, and that quickly, two away.
Henniger.
Now batting Mitch Henniger.
No, no base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
Swing and a miss. One and two.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
The 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
And a ball and two strikes. There's a swing and a drive. That's back there. Out of here. Mitch Haniger leaves the yard. His 14th of the year. And they inch closer. It's 5-4.
Exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
Here's Nicholas Castellanos. The 1-1. And a foul ball. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's down to one at 5-4. Back after this on the show. It's a new sheriff in town. Everybody get up, get down. Top of inning number 7. Now it's Jose Ramirez.
Jose Ramirez.
Next pitch downstairs, 2-1. Next offering is fouled back. Fly ball, pretty well struck right field, back there. And it's gone, home run. With one swing, he quiets the crowd. His second home run of the game. It's 6-4.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
New arm out of the bullpen, Josh Taylor. He's into the game with the bases empty. Jason Dominguez digs in for the Guardians. And a 1-1. Hard hit left side. Lindor on to first. One away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the homer.
Up next to Cleveland, the shortstop.
Patrick Connolly digs in for the Guardians. This guy with big-time power and an elite defender. Here comes a pitch. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. And now the lefty. Oh, and he hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Now, a little problem with this location there, but now the bigger problem's at first base. Tons of speed over there. He's going to have to manage the running game and find the strike zone.
Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo home run, but an important swing of the bat in this game. We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
He's
The pitch. There goes the runner. Pitch in for a strike. Throw there. Safe. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
And now before the 1-2, time is called at home plate. Connelly stands at second with two gone. Now here is Stephen Kwan. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. In there safely. So a wild pitch allows the runner to advance.
Even with a good secondary lead, sometimes it's hard to see just how far that ball's gotten away from the catcher. And if you can make it to third base, pretty much standing up. Well, that time, he seemed to have a pretty good read, gets to third safely, and now he's just 90 feet away from scoring.
Got him swinging. Guardians tack on another with this home run. It's a two-run lead now at 6-4. Trevor Stephan will take over here.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Chris Taylor up now for the Mets. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. Base knock center field. Man aboard on the leadoff single. Throw gets by him at second.
Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
And now it's 3-2.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
That one the other way. Rosario on a second. They get one. How about that double play?
I think 4-6-3 double plays like that are way tougher than these guys make it look sometimes, because no matter how you do it, the feed from the second baseman is a tough one. That's where footwork really comes into play. But right there, very well done.
Now, Henry Geronimo. Next pitch misses way outside. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. That one hammered left field. Kwan going back. Back some more. Up against the wall and brings it in. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Guardians 6 and the Mets 4. So they turn things over to the righty, Edgar Costa. He last pitched 2 days ago. So in now for Cleveland, Ahmed Rosario. Next offering is fouled back. Right-handed reliever. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And a pitch. Bounce to the left side. Lindor fires to first on the run. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. Robert Hassel the third now at the plate. And the righty deals. Not even close there. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. 2 down.
Got away with that curveball, no doubt about it. It passed right through the heart of the strike zone, and he just couldn't get the bat on it. When you strike out on one like that, that's when you start having conversations with yourself, and they're not usually very friendly.
Into the ocean. in the air on the infield. And that is that. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. They still lead it, though, 6-4. Sam Hentges gets the call from the pen.
Should be a good first matchup for him here. He's been doing a great job against right-handed bats so far this season. They've had a lot of trouble squaring him up.
The 1-1. Now a drag bunt, third base side. And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. The wind of the pitch. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy. Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
And that one hit 97 on the gun.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one. Getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Out to short. Zips it across, and that is the inning. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. And the score remains 6-4. Taking over on the mound for the Mets, Edwin Diaz. And he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. So digging in, Bo Naylor. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Really tight bite on that slider and just couldn't get the barrel to it out front. You've got to try to pull those hands tight to the body to get it through. And I'm thinking he probably wanted that pitch to end up even more inside to keep it out of the danger zone. But it had enough late break and deception to get the job done.
And the right-hander deals. And that one hammered. That's back. And it's out of here. He's done it again, and they add on. It's 7-4. He absolutely feasts on right-handed pitching and devours that one for a homer.
And you can see that's what he expects of himself. At bat after at bat, he's that confident. He's putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now. A three-homer game, man, it's so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
So up next, Jason Dominguez. Ball to strike, the pitch. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. And it falls. Throws to second. Dominguez trying to wiggle out of a rundown now. And they tag him out. Patrick Connolly digs in for the Guardians. This guy one of the best contact men in the sport as well. Out, cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Jose Ramirez with the homer here. It's now 7-4. It's Major League Baseball on the show. So Cleveland brings on a new reliever, Emmanuel Clase. 25th appearance of the year for him.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Guardians. Number 48, Emmanuel Clase.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. The pitch.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One away.
Well, I definitely say that's a statement strikeout right there. You come out of the bullpen, go right after the hitters, and three pitches later, you got one out. Tell you what, if you're in the dugout, you're looking at each other and saying, he's going to be tough to get to today.
Kick, the 3-2. Bounce to the right. Rosario tosses the first. Now only one out remaining.
Now the right fielder.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Castellanos leads off first with two down to the inning. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away. And next for the Mets, Jamai Jones. That one catches the zone. It's 2-2.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. And that'll do it. The Guardians win the rubber match of this three-game series.
Well, the goal when you go on the road is to at least play 500 ball. Well, they've been winning series. They win this one here. And you got yourself a little bit of breathing room, but you want to keep the same mindset. Let's go into the next place, and let's take that series again.
This one finishes with a final of 7-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.